De Spine Intervention Prognostic Study Group in de Leiden University Medical Center en de Medical Center The Hague tries to evaluate the highest level of evidence in spinal surgical care. The motivation for this one is that evidence is frequently lacking. In recent years, we see a steep rise of the use of spinal implants in spinal surgery. This without any scientific evidence. That's the reason why we want to investigate that in this trial.
Intermittent neurogenic claudication is caused by lumbar spinal stenosis. It ranks fifth based on hospital care costs. Bony decompression is the golden standard of treatment, although only 65% gives good recovery. To improve the success rate, in the 1980s, interspinous process devices were developed. There is only limited evidence available to show that these implants are superior to conservative treatment. Nevertheless, these implants are now widely used. We performed a trial to assess whether these implants were superior on short term compared to bony decompression. A C-shaped titanium implant is placed between two spinous processes. In that way, the implant indirectly widens up the interspinal space. Patients were randomized, stratified according to center. Allocations were stored in sealed envelopes. Envelopes were only opened after induction of anesthesia here on the OR. Patients and research nurses were kept blinded throughout follow-up. The primary outcome at 8 weeks was the Zurich claudication questionnaire. Groups were compared using intention to treat analysis. Patients and time points were compared using repeated measurement analysis. To account for the correlation between the repeated measurements of the same individual, generalized estimating equations were used. At 8 weeks, the success rate, according to the ZCQ of the IPD group, which was 63%, was not superior compared to bony decompression, 72%. Still, after 1 year, there were also no differences between both groups. On all other outcome scales, there were also no differences between the IPD group and the bony decompression group. However, the repeat surgery rate was much higher in the IPD group, 29%, compared to the bony decompression group, where it was only 8%. To conclude, there is no short-term benefit effect of the use of IPDs versus bony decompression. Furthermore, due to the high reoperation rate, the use of IPDs even prevents a good recovery. Without any short-term advantages of the use of IPDs and taking into account the high costs of these implants, we would not recommend their use. Future research should be very critical while evaluating new techniques and new implants in robust, double-blind, randomized trials.
Besides the findings of the study, there are two important facts to consider. First of all, reimbursement of spinal implants should follow evidence-based guidelines. Secondly, we did prove that blinding is possible in randomized controlled trials, even in spinal surgery.